So with this project here, because the tank that's behind us is getting taken offline, the town needed to have a minimum of 540,000 gallons worth of storage, but they didn't have any flat area to be able to do it. They wanted to use the parking lot the best they could. So the town actually contracted, and we worked with them to help get the contractor, had to bring all this crush grade in and have a compaction rate of 98%. So they brought it in and it had to go up about 4 feet all the way around so we could put the lake tank set up here on top of it to be able to provide them the temporary water system for this here. So that was a big undertaking for the town to have to be able to come out and do, but it's also very important when you're dealing with the lake tanks to make sure you have a flat surface to put these on, that they don't really want to go on any type of a grade that's there. Just for safety's sake, you don't want the tank running away. So this is a solution that we came up with the town and we had them get it and get it installed for this project. It's here. The whole purpose of this system here is to give them a minimum of 540,000 gallons worth of storage, which is 3 hours of pumping at 3,000 gallons a minute, which is a requirement by the fire department. Because the tank that's behind us getting repainted was their fire supply that was at that point in time. So that's why we're here, that's here. The HH160i is handled only fire demand if it should arise. The pumps are remote capable, so if there's a water main break, they can shut the pumps off without having to worry about the water going out all over the place. We turn the tank over 10% per day using the electric pumps there, and that's all using the custom control boxes and specific times and parameters for them to start and stop. So 10% gets turned over, and then at night we refill the tanks at 10% to come back up to a specific level based upon the pressure transducers and right flow and automated valves that we have that are here.